everybody. Did you know that the control center of a person's life is their mind? It's true. The Bible says, as a man thinketh, so is he. The word also says, whatever we give our mind to controls us. No wonder so much importance is placed on the minds, our minds being dominated by the truth and wisdom of God's word. If the word isn't dominating your mind, you can be sure that the negative thoughts of the enemy are. You see, God told his children to take his word seriously enough that it would influence everything in their lives. Deuteronomy 6:7 says, "You shall whet and sharpen them so as to make them penetrate and teach and impress them diligently upon the minds and the hearts of your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house and when you walk by the way, when you lie down and when you rise up." Now, I love the phrase "whet and sharpen them so as to make them penetrate." That's definitely taking the word to a whole new level of intensity in our lives. Besides just reading or memorizing it, we're stepping it up. You see, the dictionary describes the word "whet" as to make keen or eager, or to stimulate the appetite or great curiosity. God wants his word and his promises to be so clear and alive in us that they penetrate our hearts and minds, because they're going to produce peace and life and hope, so much so that they make us hungry and eager for more. Now, this way, the word begins to influence everything about us. The words we speak, our attitudes towards life and others, and the way we live. Instead of being overwhelmed with doubt and fear and discouragement when circumstances look hopeless and the enemy launches his attack against us, we are filled with faith and peace, and the joy of the Lord keeps us strong through every single storm of life. With that winning attitude, the Word of God goes to work for us and causes us to live in His blessing. Being constantly mindful of His ways and promises makes the Word sharp enough to penetrate our hearts and our minds and influence every part of our lives to live in continuous victory.